Welcome, Major Pandemians. This is MajorPandemic.com. Thank you very much for watching this video about the Spikes Tactical AR-15, but keep in mind I've got a ton of other videos out there on this YouTube channel. Now, I can't possibly include all the different specs and so forth that I do in the videos, so I do full-length written reviews with lots of pictures, all the extra specs on MajorPandemic.com. So take a look at my website. So today I want to talk to you about the Spikes Tactical MOD ST-15, which is their AR-15 M4 version available from Spikes Tactical. Now, a lot of people go, well, who is this Spikes Tactical guy? Well, Spikes is actually a very well revered name in the AR build community. In fact, right now I will tell you that they have a running 5 to 6 week back order log, you know, really up to 2 months it may be at this point, just because people know Spikes very, very well and know their products very, very well. As an example, the really big difference between Spikes and other manufacturers is a very amazing attention to detail, and I'll get into that as I go through the rifle. So Spikes has a couple different versions available. This happens, they have a carbine and then they have their mid-length. So if you go on their website and want a standard AR, it's available in the mid-length configuration and the carbine. I chose the mid-length. I really love the mid-length configuration. I believe it's the better of the two options, and I'll go over that in a minute as well. The bone stock kit or package available from Spikes is $859.99, so $860 out the door. It includes one Magpul P-Mag, which are the synthetic mags. Let me see if I can grab one here. And which are these, and which are the standard in high reliability, high durability magazines. Really the best you can get are the P-Mags. The other things it comes with are the Magpul Embus backup sight. So the thing is ready to shoot out of the box. Obviously, it comes with a hard case. It comes with a U.S. Army mil-spec operator and maintenance manual, which is the best manual in the world you can get for an AR format rifle, and has a variety of patches as well as information about the Spikes Tactical limited lifetime warranty. So really nice package. It comes ready to shoot out of the box with everything you need. I would have liked to see, and obviously a couple extra P-Mags, you know, two to three extra would have been nice. However, I understand they're really paying close attention to detail on all these individual products. So there's really those manufacturers out there that are delivering on a price point. And those manufacturers are really focused on, you know, we just need to get the components inexpensive enough to fit in this price point. Or this price point, and we want it to have this, but it needs to fit in this price point. And a lot of times what happens is you end up compromising on quality, compromising on parts, and that's something Spikes doesn't do. Every single part on this rifle, as insignificant as it may seem, even the handguard and grip are made in the United States, which I really like. Also, it has a full limited lifetime warranty. The other spectrum of that are really great rifles out there that are really selling based off of their marketing hype versus, and they may be great rifles and great brands, I'm not going to discount that at all, but they're really not telling you what's in the rifle, what's in the recipe, what makes your AR so darn good compared to anybody else's. And you know, many times the answer comes back and it is, well, you know, we're a great brand, you should buy from us. Well, why? What's in the rifle? Well, it doesn't matter. Don't worry about that. You know, Jedi mind trick of marketing hype that it's the best rifle because we say it is. And Spikes really took a different route. They're obviously not a brand that you're probably familiar with, so we can kind of throw the marketing hype out. At $860, they're definitely not the cheapest boys on the block. On the flip side, what they are doing is telling you exactly what is in the recipe of this AR. And when you start looking at that, that's what sold me on a Spikes Tactical. I hadn't heard of the brand before. I ended up buying their base format. They offer unlimited options. You can do a Lothar Walter barrel. You can do billet lowers, enhanced triggers. I skipped all of that, exercised amazing restraint and purchase their basic rifle. And what you get when you get one of these basic rifles is quite an eye-opener to the level of detail that they put into what would be considered, quote, their budget line. And I kind of have a thought process that if a company can't make a really outstanding budget class rifle, or, you know, an affordable rifle, then really their high-end rifles are just going to be a dressed-up version of that, you know, mediocre version that they've done. And I have to say, Spikes has done an absolute incredible job with their basic rifle. One of the things, and I can't possibly cover all these specs either in this video or even in my article, because it's literally four pages of single space specs, but there's things, for instance, it's a mil-spec ejection door assembly with a 5.3.1.2 mil standard 171 phosphate finish. No one tells you that. They don't tell you that the extended M4 feed ramps are machined before plating. Many people do that. That has kind of become a standard of quality, but they're not saying that they're doing it. I think that's kind of the point I'm making. The interior is a Mil-L 46010 dry film lube coating. Nobody tells you that they do that. It's that level of four pages of details about every single component on here that really make the Spikes Tactical stand out beyond other folks in the industry. Now, I've shot this, I put about 2,500 rounds through this, stripped it down, gave it a complete bath, and got it all prepped for this this video as well as my photo shoot. Very pleased with how it shot. It shot consistently 1-inch groups with the match grade ammo. I can get below 1-inch very consistently. Even with the cheap stuff, I'm easily under a 2-inch group with a 30-round group, which is very good. I'll take that all day long out of a standard service rifle that doesn't have a match grade barrel. And so I think from a shooting perspective, it shoots great. I've had no problems with that. Well above what I would consider the regular, I'm going to also assemble an AR class of assemblers out there. Very good accuracy. I think usually what you'll see is most of those less expensive brands kind of are going to be well into the 2-inch group range. This is done very, very well. Very respectable accuracy out of in essence, a patrol rifle. I'll take that. The optics I used was a Burris 14 power. That's what it maxed out as, variable power, but 14 power full field 2 tac milvat scope for my accuracy at 100 yards. Very happy with that. One of the things I'll point out on why I chose the mid-length configuration over other configurations out there. The mid-length offers, in my mind, three different advantages. Number one, the mid-length configuration really cuts down on the recoil impulse. So you still have that recoil impulse, but it's just a softer shove versus a pop that you get out of the carbine length. And that's just because you get the little extra length, and a little more delayed timing in the action, and that makes it a lot more comfortable to shoot. If you have the opportunity to shoot a mid-length next to a carbine with a similar spec rifle, I encourage you to do so, because it's kind of going to be an eye-opener for you. It is more comfortable to shoot. Because of that comfort and because of that less recoil impulse, you can get on target, back on target much quicker. So you will see a lot of the three-gun competitors and so forth really going to mid-length rifles just because of that fact. They can end up shooting a little quicker. Why was there a carbine link? The carbine link was really for the military class link barrel, which is the 14-inch barrel, which cycled a little bit more reliably with that link barrel. The reality is, with the civilian length of a 16-inch, the mid-length is a much, much better fit all the way around. We've just kind of, over the period of time, gotten used to the carbine length, and now you're seeing a movement back to the mid-length configuration. So that's the first reason, is kind of a comfort in shooting. Number two is really because of less impulse back into the bolt and carrier assembly, you end up getting less metal fatigue back in the bolt and carrier. And a lot of people say they run marginally cleaner as well. I can't say either way. All I can say is I put 2,000 straight rounds through this rifle without a hiccup. and which I was very impressed with. I cannot say that of one of the other carbine length ARs I own, which is a very reliable rifle from a good, well-known brand. However, not the reliability I saw with this 2,000 round test I ran through this. Did a 500 round initial break-in, didn't have any issues with during that break-in period as well. Really impressed with the reliability out of the box. I think that's important because a lot of the people are going to buy ARs are not going to probably take the time. They may shoot 500 rounds through an AR for home defense. They bought strictly for home defense in 3 to 5 years. They may not run 500 rounds through it in a couple hours like I did for a break-in. So, you know, that's the next piece. The third piece on a mid-length is it offers a lot more real estate. When you're shooting, you'll see a lot of the three gun competitors and speed shooting competitors really choke way out on the end of the guard so they can push the rifle from target to target and get on those moving targets and multiple targets a lot quicker. The other advantage, obviously, is if you are shooting off a barricade or a rest, obviously if you're shooting off a carbine, your real estate's going to stop about right here. The mid-link gives you a couple more options to get out there a little bit more and obviously offers you a little more stability a little further down the guard. So a couple different reasons I like the mid-link. As far as how it's equipped, all the standard features you would expect from a high-end AR. Six position stock, standard grip, front heavily full length heat shielding on the front guard, F mark front sight, and an A2 flash hider. The other details that you're going to see in Spike's Tactical are just a kind of a little attention to detail here and there that make you go, wow, these guys are really paying attention to each and every part, and as if the listing of the pages and pages and pages of specifications don't get you. Just merely looking at it will. So you're going to see the little details like the ambidextrous pictograms on the selector switch area on the lower receiver. Obviously they have it's labeled as a multi-cal on the receiver, which I like. Some states do require that if you switch out different calibers on uppers, that you do have a multi-cal lower. So that's a nice feature. It has an extended selector switch, which gives you a little more assured switching from fire to safe, fire to safe. And obviously includes a Magpul Imbus backup sight, so it's ready to shoot right out of the box. I like that. A lot of manufacturers are just including the flat upper with no sights on it. I think this is a nice feature, and it's definitely a great fit to the rifle. If we kind of break it down, obviously all the proper staking. The bolt is a standard bolt. Has a nice Spike's Tactical logo on here, as well as Spike's Tactical logo here. And the bolt itself is carpenter steel. Obviously, they list that on there. They tell you that also on the site that the bolt and the barrel are both high pressure tested and magnetic particle inspected as well, which is really kind of an upgrade. A lot of manufacturers don't take the time to do that, and that is an extra process. They do extra little things. Let me pull off the handguard. I'll kind of show you this. Nice heavy heat shielding on the handguard. One of the other little details, and this will kind of show you, you can kind of see that right there, that they've done a laser etching of the what is this barrel. Over a period of time, if you had this for 10 years or so, you're going to kind of wonder, what exactly was this barrel? Or if you sold the rifle. It is a ST. It's a Spike's Tactical. Mil B, which is a mil-spec rifle, mil-spec steel. Mil B11595E, which is the steel type. CMV, chrome moly vanadium, 5.56 NATO, which is the chamber, 1x7, which is the twist, CL, which is chrome line, HP, which is high pressure, and MP, which is magnetic particle, tested barrel. That's a really nice feature, and I want to point out it's that level of detail that you get on the Spike's Tactical, which kind of brings me to my point. There's a lot of manufacturers out there that are just building ARs. It's no secret. There's only a handful of manufacturers that are building parts for ARs. There are, I will point out, A grade, B grade, C grade, and D grade parts. It's quite obvious Spike's is taking the A grade or double A grade parts throughout. They include a H-marked buffer that is Spike's tactical flow goad, and they have a standard trigger. I would say the trigger is very standard, nothing special there. The bolt and so forth, but it's the, I would say, craftsmanship. It's an attention to detail through each and every part that you would find more in a craftsmanship rifle than you would somebody who simply bolts together parts. And that's what I like about the Spikes Tactical. I encourage you to take a look at SpikesTactical.com. Also point out they include an M16 bolt versus a AR-15 bolt. Nice little upgrade. And the rifle itself has a lot of really great specs. You're getting the highest quality rifle you could possibly get for the money. $860 for this quality rifle with a 1-in-7 twist, chrome lining. It has been stress relief, i.e. cryo treated, as well as high pressure metal particle tested. A lot goes through the barrel, and it was evidenced in the really consistent groups I got out of the barrel. Hope you enjoyed the video. I think it's a great, great product. Highly recommend it, and I think you would really enjoy the Spikes Tactical if you had an opportunity to pick one up. Thanks a lot, and catch the review, full review on MajorPandemic.com. We'll see you at the range.